Good evening, friends. Today, I'll discuss about the most important and most valuable topic, leukorrhea, its causes, its symptoms, and its pathophysiology, and its homeopathic treatment and management. So let's start. 25-year-old lady came in my chamber. The complaints were excessive, normal, vaginal discharge. The discharge is non-offensive and non-intact. General examination reveals that it is the case of ill health, but in reality, ill health producing leukorrhea. Vulval inspection reveals that it is white discharge or creamy discharge and no evidence of rotus. But microscopy examination is very, very necessary for this case because past cell detection is very necessary for this case. If the past cell is not detected, this is a case of true leukorrhea. And for this reason, part of vaginal smear examination is very necessary because this case reveals that presence of precancerous or cancerous cells on your cervix, and a lady will be eligible for this test when she is long suffering for this case. Now I want to talk about the burning problem, leukorrhea, its causes, its pathophysiology, and its homeopathic treatment and management. And what is leukorrhea? Leukorrhea is strictly defined as excessive normal vaginal discharge. And what it is pathophysiology of leukorrhea? Leukorrhea or excessive normal vaginal discharge is dependent on the endogenous estrogen secretion. Now I am focusing about the cause of leukorrhea. Number one, physiologic excess. Number two, cervical cause. And number three, vaginal cause. Now focusing about the number one cause, physiology excess. During pregnancy, during menstrual cycle, and during puberty. Number two, cause, cervical cause. Non-infective cervical lesion causing excessive vaginal secretion, which is poured out at the vulva. And non-infective cervical lesions are chronic cervicitis. Number two, mucus polyp. And number three, ectropion. What is ectropion? Cervical glands which is exposed to the vagina. Now, number three cause, vaginal cause, the very, very important cause for this case. Number one, chronic pelvic inflammation. And number two, uterine prolapse. Now I am focusing about the homeopathic treatment and management. And this is a very, very important point. And what is the important medicine of homeopathic medicine of leukorrhea? Number one, Thuja 200. Number two, Bobista 30. Number three, Borax 30. Number four, Piosidam 30. And number five, Calcarea Curve 200. As a homeopath, I always give the medicine on the basis of symptom similarity. So I am humble request to you, always taking the medicine please consult physician. So thank you very much.